Hi guys, this video is the last in the series of third-party charting libraries integrations. We have already learned how to connect to HiCharts, Fusion Charts, Google Charts, and AM Charts. Today's video will show you the general approach to integrating with any third-party visualization tool. Our documentation is based on D3JS, but in this tutorial, we will explain it on ChartJS. Let's start by creating a base for our new chart. Add a container to display a pivot on the page, then add a FlexMonster library in a script containing a pivot table report. Don't forget to replace X characters in the license key parameter with your key. If you don't have one, don't hesitate to contact our team and request a special trial key. Now you can see the pivot grid on the page. To display the chart, create a container for it. Look through your charting library documentation to learn how to do it specifically for your tool. Of course, add the charting library itself to the project. Then add the instance of a chart with its configuration to the script section. The example shows a bar chart, but we want to work with something more interesting, for example, a polar area chart. Now, we are adding a new configuration for the chart, deleting the unnecessary part and replacing it with the right data. Now we have both the desired chart and the pivot table on the page, but they're not connected and display different data. Let's fix it. What we need to do is to visualize the pivot grid slice and data set on the chart. We will start by adding a report complete handler to know when the pivot is ready to pass the data. Then we should add the function to create the chart. This function uses a getDataApp call that receives the slice to display. If this property is not specified, getData will return the data displayed on the grid. It asynchronously passes the data to the callback handler function, which tracks when the data is ready to be retrieved from FlexMonster, and the update handler function, which tracks if the slice or number formatting was changed. Next, we need to create a draw chart function that will get the raw data add draw a chart based on it. Also, we want the chart to be interactive and display the changes on the grid, so we will add the update chart function that will destroy the previous visualization and draw the new one. The most important thing here is to translate FlexMonster data to the format that your charting library will understand and be able to visualize. The raw data received from the getDataApp call looks like this with rows and values. It also contains metadata about the return data with the number of rows, columns, values, captions, and formats. Our function should prepare data appropriately to the format of the chosen charting library. As we are using ChartJS in this tutorial, our prepare data function will look like this. When repeating this tutorial, refer to the required format of your library. You can also find the D3JS example of this function in our documentation. Don't forget to replace the default chart data with the newly prepared data in your configuration. Now you can go to the web page and see the final result. Our polar area chart displays the aggregate data from the pivot table and reacts to all the changes on the grid displaying the new slide. Congratulations! Now you know how to integrate FlexMonster into any charting library of your choice. So thanks for watching and see you in the next video.